Hello and welcome to our next online learning session with the topic KNX Combi Switch Actuator SAH/S Shutter Functions. Beside our webinars, we are running also our online learning sessions since April. And yeah, the topic is always any special product or any feature of a product. And today it's the shutter functionality of our Combi Switch Actuators. Yeah, my name is Thorsten Reibel from the Competence Center Europe Smart Buildings, and I will run this online learning session today. What is the topic today? So again, we talk about our Combi Switch Actuators and the shutter functionality. So at the beginning, a very short overview of the components and the applications regarding shutter behind. And then the main part will be the ETS application, but only focusing on the shutter functions today. Yeah, and last but not least, I have one slide to compare our traditional shutter actuators, JRA/S, with the functions in the Combi Switch Actuator regarding shutter. There are some differences. Of course, a lot of things are the same, but I think for choosing the right device, it's quite interesting to see also the differences. So first of all, a short overview. So we talk about these components here, the KNX Combi Switch Actuators, and total 9 devices, 3 with 6 ampere, 3 with 10 ampere, and another 3 with 16 ampere. The rest is more or less the same. The manual operation, connection terminals, and so on is the same housing. We have from 8 over 16 to 24 outputs for switching at least. If you see later the number of channels for shutter, it's half of it. You will see. A lot of functions, and again, it's a combi device, means you can use it for switching, but also for any shutter solutions, and that's our topic today. Yeah, and we talk about these components. You see here the connection diagram, the mixture of connecting lamps, but also any motors, shutter blinds, curtains, whatever. And you can see here that we need 2 relay outputs to control a motor for open, close, up and down. We need 2 contacts. Different from the classical shutter actuators, we have here no changeover contact, but 2 independent relays. We operate like a changeover contact via software. Yeah, you can mix what you want. So again, you see we need 2 outputs. So a shutter channel results then in half of the number of outputs. So a 24-fold combi switch actuator is then a 12-fold actuator for shutter functions, for motor functions. Yeah, applications behind. So we distinguish normally between solutions with SLED adjustment. So typically blinds have not only open, close, up and down functionality, but also mechanical SLEDs you can adjust as well. So these are typically exterior blinds, any SLED blinds, sometimes also any panel curtains with vertical SLEDs. All these things allows us to adjust the SLEDs. So in this case, we have not only up and down and stop, but also a stepwise control. So in short steps, we can adjust this in the parameters. We can open or close the SLEDs. But sometimes you have also other applications behind, like any shutters or any screens, awnings, maybe also electrical windows, even a pool cover, where you only open and close, but of course also stop sometimes. So this is so-called without SLED adjustment. We adjust this in the parameters, but finally most of the parameters are the same. So in principle, not only shutter and blinds for shading solutions, many more applications are behind. And all these components can in principle be connected to 2 outputs of this Combi Switch Actuator to run the motor. Yeah, but we concentrate today on the ETS application. Short overview, it's only one application where you can adjust everything. Maybe some of you already participated in our former online learning sessions around the Combi Switch Actuator, where I were concentrating on the application itself with focus on switching. So I will not go into all details. For example, these programmable logic already handled in the last online learning session. So I will concentrate on the shutter functions. But to have a short overview, we have these templates also for shutters. I will explain. Then these logical functions. A lot of safety and weather alarm functionality, especially for shutters and blinds. Different time functions, but only for switching. Blocking function, we'll talk about forced operation. Scene management is integrated. These central group objects. Sometimes we find here colored hints. Gives you an information inside the ETS application if something has to be adjusted anywhere else, for example. Yeah, and last but not least, you need the ETS5 to program these devices. But if you would like to have more information about these other features in the application, here you will find the link to this former online learning session about the ETS application itself of these components. So let's go into the details of the parameters for shutter functionality. Central group object, not only available for switching, but also for the shutter functions. You see here, if you enable this, you have four group objects to open and close, move up and down the blinds, open and close the slats, and go directly to a position with a one byte object, both for the height of the hanging, but also for the slats. So a central group object means that you have a special object. You don't have to assign for central commands to all these channels, central group addresses. So you reduce the time for programming, and it's a bit more comfortable. And later in the channels, you can decide, shall be the channel part of these central functions within my device or not? So it's not absolutely a central command, but you can decide later which channel shall participate here. Yeah, and also for scene, you have here also central group objects available. So it's the same like switching, but for shutter functionality. Yeah, also templates available for the shutter functionality. Template means that you create for different parameter pages the parameterization, and then you can decide later, is this parameterization valid for other channels, maybe for all channels in one device? So then you choose only the template instead of parameterizing each channel individually, but with the same parameters, which makes no sense finally. And so you save also a lot of time and helps you to have a more economical programming. Again, in all channels, you decide, will you take this template or do you would like to have an individual programming? Yeah, and you see it's split into seven parts here, and we will go through all these seven parts to show you the parameters behind. So, and then we come to the first parameterization per channel. So we go now to shutter actuator A plus B, so to the first channel. And if you go there, you find, first of all, the decision, do you would like to have a shutter output or a switching output? Standard default is, if you open the first time the ETS application, is shutter. And shutter means that you need a pair of outputs, in my case, A and B, automatically. So B is not individually available anymore because it's shutter now, and the same for CD, EF, and so on, if you choose all for shutter. Why do we start with a shutter parameterization? So you have to change intentionally to switching. Has to do with the following. If the shutter output is programmed, it's from the, safety point of view, the best solution, because if I connect at the beginning also a shutter motor, you will not destroy anything. By using a switch actuator programming, you can operate each relay independently and close each relay at the same time, and then you would destroy the motor. Not possible with shutter functionality because there is a software interlock between both outputs. I think it's clear you cannot close, or you should not close, both contacts at the same time. So if you would like to have switching, no problem, you change it here. So we have also always a pair, and then you choose here at the next step, do you have slat adjustment, blinds, or do you have any other application where you need only open, close, up and down, and stop functions? Yeah, and then three further parameterizations you enable here. Do you would like to have a scene management? Do you need the safety and priority functions for shutter blinds, exterior shutter blinds, very important. And do you need the automatic sun protection? I will explain what's behind. Yeah, next page is your basic settings. And now you see you can choose, do you would like to use a template programming, apply from template, or do you would like to have an individual parameterization? And that's always possible in all these parameter pages for each channel. Yeah, first of all, you decide, do you would like to integrate this channel into your central function, central group object, remember? You tick it here, so very simple. Then you can say, okay, my output, my channel output, shall it react on any logic I have created? 24 independent logical functions can be created here. I have explained this in this former online learning session already. You can decide if you say no, then it's of course not related to this. Remember, this logic behind is completely independent of channels as well. So you can use it for any purpose. Yeah, and then we have here some also important parameters, reaction on bus voltage failure, bus voltage recovery, and also what happens after ETS application download. And it should be parameterized here because you don't want to have normally any undefined situation after a power failure, for example, which results very often also in a KNX bus voltage failure, and anytime it recovers. So here you can adjust different things. You can stop, you can open and close, you can have an individual position, for example. Even the automatic sun positioning can be activated. So here you have to decide what is the most convenient one for your project. Yeah, then we come to drive parameterization, also per channel. We adjust, first of all, the travel time for up and down. What does it mean? If you go from down to up, you have one time the drive is running, and vice versa as well. And we adjust this here independently because the times maybe are not the same. If you have a vertical hanging, of course, it will accelerate a bit if it's going down. So it will be faster than going up. Why do we need this? We need this for positioning. We have no feedback from the motor, where is the position of the hanging, so we do it indirectly via time. So if we start from the top and we know it's 20 seconds to go down, then we can via time really calculate the position of the hanging. So this is possible here. And there's a difference to part of our classical shutter actuator. At some of these components, we have the so-called automatic travel time detection via current measurement. Means we measure the load current, the motor current, and then we know motor started, and we start the internal timer and can automatically detect the travel time. Not possible here, so you have to measure it by yourself once, and then you type it in here in the parameters, and then it's also okay. So disconnect output from power after end position plus an overflow. Normally a motor has an end switch, so if you reach the end position of your hanging, it will disconnect the power immediately. That's necessary. We can also program here that after reaching the end position plus a small overflow time, we also open the contact to de-energize also from our combi switch actuator. So it's an additional safety function in case of malfunction of the end switch. Yeah, further feature here is, or further function is, a reference movement. What does it mean? We can start a reference movement, means the drive runs to the end position, lower or upper end position. Why do we do this? Or why this might be necessary sometimes? If you run your drive only in between, so you never reach the end positions, but you need positioning, then it might happen that it's getting unprecise over a longer time because it never goes back to zero, but can start the timing or the time counting again. So here it makes sense maybe, for example, in office building during the lunch break to start the reference movement, going back to the former position, and then nobody will take care of this more or less. But you have, let me say, reset a bit this positioning. Well, that's an option here. and you can do it via this group object if you activate this. So then we have the so-called reversing time. Reversing time means if you run the drive directly when it's going down into the up functionality, means you change the direction immediately without any stop, then there should be a stop time in between before it goes to the other direction. Just to avoid any strong mechanical or electrical load. It's mechanic behind, of course, and not every drive is happy with this. So here you adjust a so-called reversing time. Typically, you get the information from the manufacturer of the drive. This is important, but can be adjusted here. Yeah, then we have some delay times, so-called start-up delay and coasting delay. What does it mean? Some drives do not get their full power directly if you start the motor. So they take some milliseconds for continuous moving. And this is, of course, for precise positioning, a challenge. But you can compensate this here by adding additional time. Start-up delay and the coasting delay is if you stop the motor, it's still running a bit mechanically. And also this is causing maybe some lower accuracy in terms of positioning. So adjustable here, maybe you have to test this. And last but not least, also some drives need a minimum runtime. So not good for them to run only a very few milliseconds. Also here, you should take care of the recommendation of the manufacturer of the drive and also adjustable here, if necessary. Yeah, then we come to blind shutter parameter page. We can run directly via one byte group object the drive to any position. So between 0 and 100%, 0% is open, 100% is closed. You can do it directly. So if you're at 50% position, you can go directly to 80 or 30%, no problem. But you can choose also going via upper or lower or shortest way, upper and lower end position or shortest way, just to reach before you go to the next position, first of all an end position. Remember, could be interesting for higher accuracy for positioning. So it's adjustable here. So how to adjust the slats if you have a slat application behind many, maybe any blinds. Slats means I can run in steps the slats from open to close. And how many steps you would like to have from open to close, all these things are adjustable here. And you have two options to adjust this. We have duration of slat adjustment. So you say, okay, my steps I would like to have 200 milliseconds. You try this. You say, okay, it's 10% of the total turn and it's okay. And then you adjust here the number of slat adjustments to have a complete opening and closing of the slats by operation of operating 7 times here, for example. It's a bit testing what is the best, how big shall be the step of a slat adjustment. You can adjust this here via this duration. So you adjust first of all the time, or the other option is that you say, okay, I know the total time for slat turning. You get it maybe also from the manufacturer of the blinds. Maybe it's 2,000 milliseconds, 2 seconds. And then you say, okay, this is the time I have. And then you say, okay, I would like to do it in 5 steps. And then you can adjust it here as well. So you have 2 options to adjust the way how to adjust the slats. It's important if you use later these automatic sun protection together with tracking of the sun position, where we practically operate this to have the best lighting situation or brightness situation in the room. And here it makes sense to adjust this accordingly. If you use the stepwise control, typically you use it by short operation many times. Sometimes it happens that you operate too many steps, and then you do not only turn the slats anymore, but you also move the blinds up and down, which of course is maybe not what you want. And you can limit this here, so that it's not going more than the 7 steps in my case here, and then you cannot change the slats anymore. It's also quite useful. Further parameter you can activate is a so-called total turning of sleds after move down. So what does it mean? You go down and the sleds will close, open and close again. Why can you do this? Does it make sense? Sometimes a sled is not in the right position. It's hanging a bit, or it's blocked a bit, or it's got stuck a bit. And with this opening closing of the sleds, you just overcome this situation. Quite useful sometimes, and you can parameterize this here. Then, and the next parameter is here, what shall be the position of the sled if you go to the end position? So if you go completely down, maybe you don't want to have it completely closed as well with the sleds. You say no, hanging is down, but 50% open of the sleds, please, to get some brightness from outside into the room. Also here, adjustable. Yeah, and then we have still under blind shutter, this limitation of the travel range. You can say, okay, I don't want to completely close or completely open my blinds or shutters. I would like to limit this. And you can adjust it here. You can say, okay, between 20 and 80% maybe you would like to have the movement only. And this you can also enable or disable for different functions. We distinguish here between the direct commands and the so-called automatic sun protection. And in both cases, you can choose, shall it be valid, the limit, or not valid. And what means direct commands? the typical standard functions behind, like moving up and down the blind or sled adjustment, move to position per one byte object, but also the sleds, or activating a scene. And the other very often used function is then the automatic sun protection. So really very flexible to adjust also this limitation according to your requirements. Yeah, and then finally here some dead times, so-called, you can adjust. What is a dead time? Defines the time where the hanging is not moving, though motor is turning, so mechanical slippage of the hanging, not of the motor, of the hanging, of the mechanic. And this is typical because there's some mechanic behind. Though the motor is already turning, there is no real movement behind. Also this you can compensate here by adding here some times. It has to be tested finally, yeah, but the option is available. So for the dead time from button until moving up, if it's moving from the lower position, for the sleds the same, and sometimes for changing direction you have also mechanical slippage, and also this you can compensate here. Yeah, coming now to the safety weather alarms, very important for exterior blinds and shutters to protect your hanging against any weather impacts like wind, rain or frost. To do this, of course, you need an external sensor to detect the situation. And we have two options in our KNX range here. It's a so-called weather unit together with this weather sensor. So it's one package in principle. And this weather sensor has a typical weather data like rain, temperature, wind, but also brightness. So very often used for residential projects or small commercial ones. But we have also another solution. You take the weather station, which is in principle an analog input with special parameters for weather sensors. And to the analog inputs, you connect from any conventional weather station or weather sensors, all these sensors, be it 0 to 10 volt or 4 to 20 milliampere input. And then you parameterize it, and you have also here the values or the thresholds available. So this is necessary. But let's concentrate on the parameters around this. So we have again for the device, not for the channel first of all, but for the device, some parameters. More or less we enable our weather sensors. Up to 3 wind sensors can be assigned. If you have a very complex building with different facades where different wind situations appear, 3, but also rain could be critical. Think about any roofs or any awnings which are sensitive, and even some frost situations can be critical for any hangings, for any material. So you enable this only here for the whole device, and later you can decide in the channels which of these sensors shall be assigned to my channel. One feature which is very typical for weather sensors, we can monitor the signal from the weather sensor or from the weather station by sending cyclically the telegram from the sensor. No problem to do. To monitor the sensor signal, we can program here a monitoring time, and then we expect within the monitoring time at least one signal from the sensor. If not, then something is wrong and we can react accordingly. The blinds go up, for example, going to a safe position. You can deactivate this cyclical monitoring, but for these sensors, really recommended. It's standard in shutter application, blind application with wind sensors, typically. So in my case, 30 seconds monitoring time. Maybe I send every 20 seconds cyclically from the sensor, so then I'm normally safe in receiving the signal within this time. Yeah, going now to the channel again, shutter actuator A and B, where we can parameterize for the channel this information or this weather data. So first of all, we choose which of these three wind sensors shall be assigned to this channel A and B. You can also take three, but typically you have only one. But maybe shutter actuator CD, other channel, is linked to a blind at another facade of the building where you have different wind situations, and you take maybe wind alarm number two in this case. Yeah, and then you decide what shall happen in case of wind. Typically for blind you go up, but you have a lot of options, not only up and down, but you can also stop if it's just running. You can keep it unchanged, you can activate a scene or any individual position, both for the height but also for the sled can be adjusted here. Yeah, and the same you do for a rain alarm if you would like to enable this or have enabled this here, or frost alarm. This is also possible. We have further, besides these three weather-related safety functions, we have also two others to operate the channel behind in a special way. One is the so-called blocking object. Blocking means I can, of course, run the motor once again into a position, but then I block it for any further operation. So nobody can run the blinds. For example, you have to clean the windows and there is somebody outside. Then, of course, the shutters or blinds should not run at that time. Yeah. Also adjustable here. So blocking is one feature. And what else is available? So-called forced operation. You know this maybe from other components also here, but you have two options here with a 1-bit, but also with a 2-bit object. Practically also you run the drive into a certain position. With 1-bit you have only one position available. With 2-bit signals or telegrams, you can parameterize two different positions here. So 1-bit telegram can come from any push button, of course. A 2-bit telegram, it's more something for visualization, where you have this data type available. And you see here, with value 2 and 3 decimal, you activate one of these two forced operations. The other 0 and 1 is only deactivation of forced operation. So practically, you have five functions, three times wind, rain, frost, and blocking and forced operation to operate your motor with different priorities. So for example, forced operation, you can say, okay, in case of fire alarm, I would like to open all the roof windows with the highest priority, so nobody can close this anymore. Even the rain cannot close these roof windows. So it gives you a lot of flexibility and options to create your individual solution. Yeah, and the priority between all these five functions you can adjust here. Weather alarms you do directly in these device-related programming, and then you decide what happens with blocking and forced operation, in which sequence or priority sequence you would like to have this. So you have all options here to create your own priority. Yeah, but I forgot here at the beginning some more parameters. What happens if you reset weather alarms or this blocking or forced operation? Also here you can say, okay, no wind alarm anymore. What shall happen with my blind? Anything is possible. up, down, stop, any position and whatever. All these things are possible. Also, if you reset these alarms, you can decide what shall happen with your automatic sun protection. But I come to this in one of the next slides. Yeah, we are already here, automatic sun protection. What does it mean? We have two possible functions here in the combi switch actuator. One is a so-called standard sun automatic. Practically, of course, you measure the brightness. And then you decide what shall happen if the sun is shining. Typically, you close your blinds, maybe 100% down, and all the slats are completely closed. But you can also activate any position. If there's no sun, you open the blinds. And if you want, you have a local push button to deactivate and activate this automatic mode. It's also possible. So this is so-called standard sun automatic, nothing special. A more powerful one is the following, blind control depending on sun position. So you see here on the right the way it works, also depending on sun. We operate our blinds, and here typically you have blinds with slats, because not only the position, the height is important, more important is the position of the slats to keep the sun outside, but to have as much natural light in the rooms as possible. What does it mean practically? We have a dynamic situation. We have to track the sun position to know where the sun is right now, and then we position accordingly here our slats or the height of the hanging. And this has to be done by an additional device, a so-called shutter control unit, JSPS. Not new, already existing for many years in combination with our other switch, shutter actuators. It's also possible for combi switch actuators. You will see it in the parameter adjustments. Practically, of course, we have to measure the sun, and depending on the threshold of the brightness outside, we activate this automatic sun protection, as just mentioned. Possible is to activate and reactivate this automatic sun protection in different ways. You can do it via a separate group object. You can do it also via time, means if you deactivate automatic sun protection after 5 hours, it returns back automatically. It's also possible. Yeah. And then we have some objects here to block completely automatic sun protection or to block also, enable also the other direct operations. Also here flexibility, how or when shall it run this automatic sun protection. Yeah, and what shall happen in case of automatic sun protection? You can, again, with a simple solution, go to any position, fixed position, or even more powerful with a shutter control unit, you use here the parameter or the parameter position for sun gleich equal one. Receive height and slat via group objects. So the shutter control unit calculates the right position, sends out a 1 byte value to this combi switch actuator, and then it will be positioned accordingly. And this happens every half an hour, every minutes, maybe, depending on your changes. And you see or you hear sometimes a click and the motor is running still a bit more and opening or closing the slats a bit more. All these things then are possible. Of course, if there's no sun anymore, you undershoot the threshold you have programmed, then you can also react whatever it means. You open completely or go to 50%, whatever you want. So this is automatic sun protection, and we are coming to the end. Two parameter pages still open. One is the status messages to get a feedback of the actual situation of your hanging of your blinds, whatever. And here you have a lot of options. You have the option to get the position of the hanging itself or the position of the slats, 1 byte object. You get also, if you want, the information, is your drive in the end position, lower or upper end position. Could be interesting for the following constellation. Maybe you have a window, electrical window, and a curtain in parallel. And both open or both operate at the same time would be critical. You cannot open or you should not open the window if there is the curtain closed. This way you can interlock between these two, let me say, channels. You say, okay, if The window is open, you cannot close the curtain. That's not possible, and vice versa. This way possible. Yeah, then we have operability status, means is the drive able to run? Is it not blocked due to any safety alarm, weather alarm, or due to any manual operation? Can be assigned to the local push button in the room to see, okay, if it's red, no operation possible locally. You see, is the automatic sun protection active? And for visualizations especially, a one-byte object to give you multiple status information, which can be then assigned to a text in a visualization, then you have a real text-oriented status information. Also quite useful sometimes. Yeah, and then last but not least, when you send out these pyramid, as these group objects of status, status maybe is not necessary all the time. You can, let me say, administrate here the number of telegrams. Typically, you can say, okay, I would like to send only on case of change these status information, or if I send a request, I would like to have the status only, then I need the status, not all the time. All these things are adjustable here, and especially in visualizations, you don't maybe have to update all the time. If you need the status, you click a request button and then you get the status only. Reduce the traffic on the bus a bit. Yeah, and last one, scene, one byte scene, not new, existing in DALI gateways and all our switch actuators and other components. Also here available for our shutter and blind functionality, means we can create up to 16 one byte scenes. Scenes can be recalled, what you have programmed here, but you can also store new scenes. We have also an additional one bit object available for the first four scenes, a one bit object to recall the scene, which is easily possible from any product, or you take the standard one byte scene object, which allows to recall and to store any of these 16 scenes. We can also parameterize a delay. So maybe you have a big scene, hundreds of shutters, you would like to open them at the same time, create a scene, and then you say, okay, I don't want to overload my electrical installation. For each 10 blinds, I create a delay of 1 second maybe, and then you have more or less stepwise control, but less current or less power from the electrical network required at the same time. Yeah, and of course the most important thing is, what is the position of the height and the sled in case of scene assignment, in which position it shall go. So this is so-called one-byte scene management, and here one picture. Finally, one-byte scenes, as mentioned, available in many more components, and here in the middle, my combi switch actuator with some blinds, which go in different scenes to different positions. Good, so this was the whole range of parameters here in this application, but only for shutter. We did not talk about switching, which is a separate part, but I did it already in the past. Yeah, finally, I have one slide left to show the differences between the combi switch actuators and the shutter actuators, JRAS, according to or related to the shutter parameters or shutter functionality at all. Not only the software, but also a bit hardware. And I concentrated on the main differences, but I think I covered most of it. So you see here the combi switch actuator, and on the right the shutter actuator, JRAS, and some features on the left. And you see the differences here quite well. So the number of channels for shutter from 4 to 12 with the combi, with the other shutter actuator up to 8. 2, 4, 6, and 8 is available. We have the option of switching, of course, in the combi switch actuator. It's a full functionality available, and more channels, of course, because each relay is an independent switching output then, up to 24. Here we can do it as well. A changeover contact can be used for switching one like a relay function, let's say, but we cannot double the number of channels because it's only one contact then used in the changeover contact. Relay current goes here up to 16 ampere in the combi version. We have only 6 ampere for the shutter actuators. which is in most of the cases sufficient, no problem. But maybe you need, in special situation, a higher current. You can use a combi switch actuator. Sometimes you need DC motors to be controlled, low voltage DC motors. Think about electrical windows, think about indoor curtains. Due to security reasons, it's not 230 volt, but 24 volt or 12 volt, 48 volt, so low voltage. Not prepared here for the combi switch actuator, but in our shutter actuators, we have a special version to do this. So here is DC operation available, this low voltage with one 4 volt device. It's an advantage here. As mentioned, combi switch actuator is implemented with two relays. I need two relays to run a motor. Here is a changeover contact. Here we have no mechanical locking. Here, of course, a shutter actuator with changeover contact. You cannot close both sides of the contact at the same time. Mechanically, not possible. So it's maybe an advantage that some ask for this. IBUS tool support, yes, available for shutter actuators, coming soon for the combi switch actuators. Not yet available, but very soon, still this year. So our colleagues are working on this. It will be available. Blind control depending on sun position, yes, in both. We have talked about this. Travel time detection via current measurement, not possible in the combi. With a version in the shutter actuator with 5 in the middle, yes, available. Switching functions parameter, limited in the shutter actuator, more or less nothing, let's say, only staircase lighting and inversion of the output is possible. It's made for ventilation flaps originally. Of course, in the combi, it's full functionality and no limit. Yeah, and then in the ETS application for shutter, we have also some differences. So the central object, 8-bit scenes with a delay, and the additional 1-bit object is only here available. Logic functions and templates. Not for the shutter actuator JRAS, but it has also some specialties. 1-bit presets, so with a 1-bit telegram, you can run the drive in a certain position for are available. 8-bit scenes as well. Heating, cooling, automatic, and overheat control. That's really not available here in the combi, but in the shutter actuator JRAS. In short words, heating, cooling, automatic means, you know, is your building in heating or cooling mode, winter, summer? Is somebody in the room via presence detector? And is the sun shining? And then, depending on this situation, you adjust your blinds accordingly. Yeah. So in winter, you would maybe open the blinds, though nobody's in the room if the sun is shining, to heat up free of charge the room. In summer, you would do the opposite, of course. Yeah. This is possible. And overheat control has to do with also room temperature. If the room temperature due to sun situation is warming up very fast, then you can close the blinds immediately to avoid this. So it's a room temperature measurement or detection and then a threshold to run the blinds in this case. So you see some differences. I think in many cases we can use both, but in some cases maybe you have to decide. This was my last slides. Allow me to come to the final, typical slides, final information. If you need information about the products, of course, you find everything on our homepage, the manual and more. Our training qualification database has also a lot of former webinars and online learning sessions around shutter, also around this combi switch actuator, of course, if you would like to go to more switching functions. We have also published everything on the YouTube channel regarding the recording of our webinars and online learning sessions. Also here available, some more if you want. What else will come very soon also for you? We have done already in the past a kind of training package around shading in buildings. So there are a lot of more presentations behind, mainly related to the traditional shutter actuators. We will update this now with this part here of the combi switch actuator. So it's not only presentation, it's also an exercise, it's also an ETS project. And we will give you the link to this in our official feedback email. And we will split it in two parts, in a learning package for everybody. And a more, let me say, internal one, ABB internal one training package, which has some more details, but the main content is the same, let's say. But wait for the feedback email, then you get a link to, you can download then everything. Yeah, our training calendar with all our activities, a bit limited. We have no classroom trainings at the moment due to the actual situation. And now we have to say also our planned certified courses, at least in July, will not take place. We cannot handle this at the moment due to the actual situation, but we would like to, of course, do it a bit later. So July is not possible. October, November, we will see when and how, but we are still working on this. We are still optimistic that we can do this still this year. We will see what is possible. Yeah, and our next online learning session will be then on Tuesday, the 18th of June. We come to the push control touch with alarm functions. More will come for the next future for sure. We are working on more. So if you have any ideas, let us know. Give us a feedback. What shall be content of such an online learning session? And also webinars we are continuing. And here a small change as well. We had to change the date so a bit later as originally planned. But it will be then the 24th of June, and topic will be again our Dali Gateway, but with a complete different topic, emergency lighting. We got a lot of feedback that more information is needed here, so we decided to concentrate on emergency lighting together with our KNX Dali Gateways. And we are able to support this, to handle this completely, so have a look then, 24th of June. Then I say thank you for your participation. I sent you still today the presentation as a PDF file at least. Later the official feedback email. Hope to see you next time as well. We will invite you. Thank you for your participation. See you. Bye-bye. Ciao.